remind you that it is in the schools of Great Britain that boys and girls, like you, are learning to live in friendship with your neighbours, to respect the law, and to trust in God. Virtues which all combine to give the English people that courage and sense of fair play for which they are known throughout the world. Now, more than ever before, Britain and the dominions and colonies of the Commonwealth which she founded need men and women of courage and character to continue to keep them safe and strong against their enemies.
I've had just about enough of this. This is not the first time, so don't contradict. You have done it before, so there.
No, I've not.
You've done it to me.
When?
On several occasions.
Bollocks.
And you've...
When? Go on, when?
And you've done it to other members of staff.
Bollocks!
Yes, you have. And don't interrupt.
You're calling me a liar.
This is a final warning. And watch your language.
What you gonna do?
It's disgusting.
Hit me? You gonna hit me?
Can I go in?
Oh, hello. We have a new girl here today.
You hit me and you won't get home one night.
I don't think that hitting you would do the slightest bit of good. Even if we could, you wouldn't feel a thing. Now, are you going to get into that classroom? Or shall I arrange to have you sent home?
Sent home, please. Can I go now?
I'll see what I can do. Now, get in.
Can I go in, please?
Fucking wait a minute.
Watch your language, boy.
Expel me, right? Then I can get on and do something more useful.
Whoever would employ you?
My dad. Smart ass. I need bugger all from you. I'm gonna be making more than you'll ever make, sat in your ass in this shit heap.
You're late again.
I've got responsibilities.
You're still late.
Have you taken the register? Do I get my mark?
You're here. You get your mark. Now get in.
Jarvis. think it's time we made an example of this fellow. I'm not going to have yobbos tramping all over my staff.
He wants to be expelled.
Well, does he now? In that case, we'll suspend him and put him up in front of the whole school before he goes.
Make him a hero?
Not when he has to come back. Ignominy. And if he does it again, we'll call in the police and have him for assault. Good. I'll work that into my letter to the parents when I inform them of the suspension. How does that suit you, Ellen?
Better. We'll all be a lot safer for his absence.
That's quite right. Any other problems?
No other problems.
Useful. Go and ask that woman where she keeps her pilchards.
Which one?
That woman. Ask her for a tin of pilchards. Make her show you.
All right.
Where are the pilchards placed?
Canned meats.
Where's that?
Down the end of that line.
Can you show me the place?
It's just down there. End of this line, canned meats.
What's pilchards doing in canned meats?
Well, they're all in tins, dear.
Right, Bill. I know where they are. How? Bunking off.
Dunno. Not long. It's bloody messing here.
My brothers. They buy fish and chips to stay up late and that.
Bugger that.
Ain't a mess. Just the table, the rest is clean.
You should make them clear out, lazy sods.
Does your mum know you bunk off? Nah. How many you got in your class?
Dunno. About 20.
They bunk off?
Most of them.
What do you want to bunk off for?
What are you asking me for? You bleed in bunk off, don't you?
They catch you, they do you, they put you in court. Done me. Done me 8 times.
Then you ain't so bloody smart, are ya?
Bunk off.
Dunno. Just walk around the streets, go with the venture. Too many bullies down there at school. They pick on me because I'm little.
You want to kick him in the bollocks? I'll leave you alone then.
I bleed in 80. I throw up. I throw up every morning when I go there. I feel dizzy. I feel bloody awful.
Sit over there, you're in the way.
There's a lot of bullies in that school. Teachers too. They bush your back, always shouting at you. Do something. Trying to show you up if you're thick or something. The teachers shouldn't be what they are, right? They're all meth. All sort of flesh. Not flesh, you're like... When your mum comes, everything's ever so nice. Two-faced baggers. Soddy, ain't going near no more.
You can sit there if you want. I've got to go and make the beds. Oi! You can't lay there all day. If you want me to do your room, you've got to get up.
Who's there?
My brother. The young one. He's older than me, but he's the younger one. Lays in bed all day.
Lazy sod.
You ain't got nothing else to do.
Over the wood, I spy Robin Hood. Charlie, can you see Robin Hood? Can you see him hiding there? That's the Wicked Witch. Can you see Robin Hood? Charlie, here's Angie. Come on.
Bye bye, Charlie.
That's it. Mind you. Let's
see the dog.
Hello.
Come on, let's get your coat. Angie, Mr. Flower says he can offer him a day place, but I'm afraid he won't be able to start for another 6 months.
Oh, that's great, isn't it, Charlie? Then you can stay on to dinner.
I'll let you know. Get them to send you a letter.
Thanks.
Bye-bye, Charlie.
Say bye.
Bye-bye.
Come on, let's go and get your dinner, would you, Mum? Make an old ham, eh?
Thank you. Angela?
Yeah?
Brian Jellis, Education Welfare Officer. I think you know me, don't you?
Of course.
May I come in?
I ain't gonna say no, am I?
Thank you. Who's this?
You come to put me in court?
I hope not. This is your little brother, yes?
No. He's my brother's kid. My older brother.
And where's your father?
Work.
Where does he work, your father?
Railways.
Good. And your mother's,
Dead. Do you want a cup of tea? There's a packet of fags. You can sit down if you want.
Thank you. Well, you've been doing it again, haven't you, Angela? Getting your mark in the morning and bunking off.
I was there for geography on Tuesday.
Your name seldom appears on the lunchtime register. And we've checked your class registration. Not much improvement on last time, I'm afraid.
I can't get my dinner mark. I have to pick up Charlie.
Where's Charlie's mother?
I don't know. She left. Buggered off.
So, who looks after Charlie?
I do.
Well, how can you look after him if you're supposed to be at school?
It's only afternoons I have to look after him.
But you're supposed to be at school.
I am. Goes to my mates on Tuesdays and Fridays. Then I go to school.
He's, making a bit of a mess, isn't he? So, the reason you're not attending school is because you're obliged to stay at home to look after your brother's little boy. That's correct, is it?
I don't have to do it. I like looking after him.
Who's your social worker right now?
I've had loads. I can't keep count. Do you want coffee or tea?
Whatever, no bother.
It's you that's got a drinky.
Coffee, I'd like coffee, thank you. How many social workers have you had?
Three, four, I don't know.
Who's your social worker right now?
Miss Barker.
Ah, yes, Joyce.
You don't know nothing, though. She's too young.
Well?
But she's all right.
That's not for you to say, really, is it?
Dunno.
Has she helped with Charlie?
I think so. She got him in the nursery down the road.
So, with all his help, why aren't you at school?
Dunno. Don't like it much.
How do you get on with other children?
All right.
Do you have any problems with bullies? There was a time when you were being bullied.
There were loads of bullies down at school.
Who?
Loads of them.
Who bullied you?
A boy called Kevin.
Kevin who?
There's the milk and there's the sugar.
Is this still going on?
Nah. I took a pair of scissors and told him I'd stick him in here if he bothered me again.
What happened?
He stopped and said he'd be my friend.
What do you want to do when you leave school?
Catering.
There's a lot of competition. You'll need qualifications. You have to make an impression. That's what it's like in the grown-up world. If you want to get a worthwhile job for yourself, then you've got to get yourself some qualifications.
There ain't no jobs.
No, he's going to slip on there in a minute. Well, is there any particular subject you're having trouble with?
No.
Your reading, your maths, something like that.
I like maths. It's good. I like it.
Well, what subjects don't you like?
Games. I hate games.
You only have games once or twice a week.
Yeah, but I have to do it, don't I? Why can't I choose?
If everybody was free to choose, they'd only choose the easy subjects, the ones they enjoy.
Maths ain't easy.
Sometimes we have to
be... It ain't easy, but I like it.
Then that's why you choose it. Sometimes we have to be told what to do to, well, for our own good. It's going to be tough when you leave school.
It's tough now.
You're going to need all the help you can get. Now, you have to go to school.
But I don't learn nothing.
School can teach you things that you'll be able to use for the rest of your life.
School don't teach me nothing I need now. I must be thick or something. Nothing stays in my head.
Everyone's bored at school, even the teachers.
Teachers are there to help you, look. But he's going to fall in a minute, I know.
No.
Look, the floor's terribly wet.
It's all right.
Is this a game he plays a lot?
No, he's never done it before.
Well, it's a bit dangerous, isn't it? He could easily fall.
He's always falling over.
He's making a hell of a mess. If water gets under that linoleum, you're going to have rot. Do you realise that?
I'll stop him in a minute.
Look, I think you should stop him now. I really do, before he falls and hurts himself. If I was... I think you should stop him now. Teachers are concerned for you. If you have a problem, then you can take it to your teacher.
I've done that. I don't care. Mr. Davies always starting on me, shouting at me like I was thick or something. So I argue back and they put you in detention. Like I'm the one who's always wrong. If I have an argument with a teacher, why can't I just have an argument and be done with it?
I thought we were talking about going to your teacher for help.
Why do teachers have to prove they're right all the time?
Angela, if a teacher is concerned for you, then you must accept that what they're trying to do, what they're asking you to do, is in your own best interests. If you constantly truant all the time, then they... Well, we have to do something about it. That's what we're here for. That's our job.
Some teachers are good. Really good, right? Miss Page. She treats everyone the same. Never used to shout. I was treated like shit. They do, because they got their favourites and that's it. They're going to pass their bloody exams. If you ain't taking the exams, they ignore you. Don't want you in their class.
You can't expect to like everybody, Angela.
You ain't listening.
I am. I've listened to every word you've said. Look, you go to school to learn. That's the whole point, to learn. But you've done very well at school in certain subjects, above average for your age. But you could do very well. Now, if you've got problems here at home...
I ain't got no problems.
If you can't cope with it all...
I ain't got no problem.
I think we ought to try to sort it out.
You! You're my problem. Why don't you leave me alone? I've got a great life. My business is my business. What goes on in my home is my business, my dad's business and my brother's business. No one else's. Why don't you just leave us alone? Get down there and sort out those buggers who mugged me in the playground. Set the police on them. I was mugged at school. They nicked money from me.
Well, why didn't you report this?
I did. Makes no difference.
If you've been assaulted, then it's a matter for the police.
They don't care.
Who's this?
It's Mr. Jealous, the education welfare bloke. He's come round because I've been bunking off.
Why don't you leave her alone, man? She's okay.
What do you want?
I want some coffee. And what are you doing, boy? Look at the mess in here, will ya?
Leave him alone.
What do you mean, leave him alone? Look at it, he's swimming in here. Get out of the way.
Leave it, I'll do it. You don't need water, the kettle's already boiled. Just bag off back to bed, I'll bring it.
I'm up, I ain't going back to bed. What's he been doing?
Then take a cup of coffee and go. Stop going on about the bleeding mess. Leave my fags alone. Here.
One, I just need one.
And don't put the spoon back in the sugar.
I'll take it with me.
This is going to end in another court appearance, isn't it?
This is your last warning. I don't want to see your face in this court again.
So why not get back to school and sort out your problems? I'd like to help you sort out your problems.
But I tell you and you don't listen. Whatever I want to do, I can't do it. It ain't just me, is it?
This is going to end in court, Angela.
That's what I said when you come in.
Brian Jelly, CWO. I've got a meeting. Can you squeeze me in?
Sorry, chum. I'm conquering here today. You'll have to park out here.
Sorry. It's a restricted area, isn't it? I'll get a ticket.
Well, if you go down a bit, no.
Where?
You go down one, three streets. Take the third turning on the right, turn on the left. You'll be all right down there.
All right. Thanks.
Just come back here a minute till I want a word with you. Shh. What are you doing?
Nothing.
Yes, you are. You're not supposed to be out here. You're truanting, aren't you?
No.
I think you are. Shut up, you lot! Who's your head of year? Just stop that, do you hear? Just stop it.
Joyce. Hello.
Brian, just a minute. They're here.
Right.
Would you like some tea or coffee?
Oh, thank you, Margaret. Coffee. Alan?
Oh, yes, coffee. That would be very nice.
Right.
Thank you.
I've organised that. Tina? Sorry about that. I was just...
Oh, of course. Alan? Alan Bartlett?
Hello.
Angie's head of year?
Yes, of course.
Joyce is Angie's social worker.
Right.
We had a hell of a job parking.
Joyce,
oh, yeah.
That's why we're late.
Yes? Oh, do you want some coffee?
I've taken their orders, dear.
Right, Joyce, let's go and deal with your rhino.
Pardon?
Brian, shall we go through? Hello, Barry Clark.
Alan Bartlett, Angie's head of year.
Who's taking notes, Tina or Margaret?
Tina.
Okay.
Is Angela in school today?
Well, she was here for this morning's register, and I know that she went in for her first class, but whether or not she's still there, I couldn't tell you.
Each time Angie's gone into court, we've argued for one reason or another. We've argued for a supervision order. That's what we've recommended every time. That's all there in the notes. I think we've reached the limit. 8 times in court is the absolute limit. The supervision order has been totally ineffective. There's no teeth in a supervision order. At least with a care order, there's a kind of recognition of a problem and that something's going to be done to put things straight. And Angie has got problems. There's no mother. And the father and the brothers virtually seem to use the home as a doss house.
The father's a nice enough man.
Yes. He doesn't really do anything for Angie, does he? With that kind of background, her expectations and aspirations are going to continue to slide. I think we should make a big change for her. I think we've got to get her into care, and my own feeling is out of London. My suggestion would be a residential boarding school.
I'm bound to say I do agree with that.
Right.
I favour Hillside Residential in Norwich. I think I could find a replacement there.
If you go straight for it, Joyce, you're not going to get it. I've got a dozen cases waiting for that kind of placement. If taken out of her home and her proper school and packing her off to Norwich or wherever, if that's the best thing for her, then let's do it properly. Otherwise, we're just not going to get the cash. It's going to need a very careful period of assessment before we can go back into court with our recommendation.
Yes.
And that may not be a residential boarding school.
But we know the priorities. Where's she going to get her education and where's the best place for her to live?
She's already got a school, right? That's where she's supposed to be getting her education.
She's an habitual truant.
Okay, but the school has responsibilities to the child. Before we consider anything else, what are the chances of getting her back into a proper school?
Well, that's what we've been trying to do.
Alan?
Well, it's very difficult to assess the intelligence of a child who's hardly ever there.
What are the chances of getting her back to school?
Very little, I'd say.
We've not had much luck so far.
Is she a duffer or what?
Oh, no, she's certainly not a duffer. Her early reports are very good. She's literate. She has numerate ability, but it's almost impossible to assess her level.
Is she below average?
Oh, yes. I'd say she is now, yes.
Well, what's she like when she is at school?
Sullen. Full of resentment. A large, indolent lump in the middle of the classroom.
Yes, it's very hard work talking to her.
Truanting seems to be her only passion.
What's been done in the past? Any special provision?
She was referred to a behavioural unit. That was one of the first moves, just over 2 years ago, soon after the mother's death.
Really? I didn't know about this.
What happened?
She just got ill. Just didn't go. Then she asked... Yeah, she asked herself to be brought back into the normal school. But it's all on the record. It's all here in the notes. Also, we must remember, this was very close to the mother's death. That has to be considered a major factor. And she's had trouble with bullies. Probably picked on her for being fat.
What about Ed Sykes? Have you been called him?
There have been referrals. Wait a tick, I've got something on that.
It all goes back to the mother's death, doesn't it?
I think so.
She's very solid in a way.
Here it is. Appointments were made for her to see an educational psychologist on four separate occasions, but they were never kept.
She bunked off from those two, eh?
She's so elusive. I've tried to pick her up and take her to school, but when I get there, she's gone or they won't open the door.
That's what happened to me. The first time I knocked and banged, no answer. But when I was there in the afternoon, the brother, the younger brother, came staggering into the kitchen. He'd been there all the time.
Okay. So as it stands, all attempts to get her into school have failed, is that correct?
Yes.
She seems pretty determined to stay out, yes.
Alan. If we took her out, put her into care, got things straightened out, are we going to get her back into school?
Not with that record, no. You're not going to get her a place, are you? I can't think of a school that would take her.
No, I'm talking about her school, your school, the school she's going to now.
She's not going to school.
But if we get her straightened out, will the school take her back at a later date?
I can't see it. No. I've discussed this with Pierce, the HM, and he's very emphatic about it. Angela is a low achiever. And truancy has a kind of snowball effect. It constantly reinforces the child's feelings of being a low achiever, and that in turn leads to further problems at school. I can't see how she'll ever catch up.
She has to go to school. We have to put that straight, don't we? We have to worry about that. I've talked to Angela. You see, I have to sympathise with a lot that Alan has to say about this. I mean, first impression, she's friendly. Quite affable, really. But there's nothing constructive in her basic attitude. You talk to her, reason with her, and she nods, but she's actually being very obstructive because she just goes on in her own sweet way. I can't see how we can hope to get her back. I agree with Joyce. I feel we must seek some kind of alternative arrangement.
All the children who truant from our school usually end up in trouble with the police.
Angela's not been in trouble with the police.
She's been in court, what is it, seven?
Eight.
Eight times.
That was for non-attendance.
Well, truancy's only part of it, isn't it? As soon as it starts, the child is heading towards other things. Towards crime, in fact.
Oh, I'm sorry, I don't agree. Truancy's not evidence of delinquency.
In our school, it is.
Angela has no known criminal record, we mustn't forget that.
And she's black. We mustn't forget that, either.
What's being black got to do with it?
The fact that she's black leaves her with a very poor self-image.
I'm not sure I know what that means.
We have problems. Big problems with the West Indian children. That's what I mean. I'm sorry, but it's a fact. We have a much higher rate of criminal activity, of truancy, of maladjusted and disruptive behaviour, and a much higher rate of referral to special units for black children than for white. Right across the board. I'm sorry. But it's a fact. They unquestionably generate problems. It sticks in my throat to have to say it, but it's the truth. I have to deal with it every day at school, in my work. I see it. Now, I think that what Joyce is suggesting for Angela would be marvellous for her. She's bright, she's intelligent, and she deserves a second chance. Look, I'm sorry, but I have to leave. I really am sorry.
Bunking off, eh?
It's difficult. We've got exams coming up, and I've got a couple of high flyers that I'm hoping to push through.
Are they black or white?
Now then, Joyce.
One of them is black, actually. Carry on, I'll just go.
Great, Alan. Nice you were here.
See you, Brian.
I'll drop in.
Well, if we can't get into a normal school, that rules out fostering or a community home.
They're not West Indian, they're English.
We know that, Joyce. They're all English, right? Even the Chinese ones, they're English too, okay? There's no way they're going to take her back. I don't know why you bothered to come. You can't get rid of her fast enough. I'm sorry, Brian, but it's true. I don't blame him. Right. Family. Mum's dead. What's Dad like?
Not home very much. Difficult to track down. Doesn't say very much when you do. He's attached to Angela. Fond of her. But I don't think he can really cope. He's only been to court with her on one occasion.
Is he working?
Yes.
Perhaps that's why he wasn't in court.
Well, he works on the railways. It shouldn't have been impossible.
There are two brothers, aren't there?
Gary and Darren. They're both unemployed.
Which one lies in bed all day?
Gary.
Then it must be Darren. Angela said Darren was out to work.
No, he's unemployed. Well, he's registered as unemployed.
Well, that's not our line of business.
No.
What about the little lad?
Charlie.
A beautiful child.
Who looks after Charlie? Whose child is it?
He belongs to Darren, the elder brother. There's been various kinds of assistance from the social services. The father does very little. He's typical in that respect. The baby just gets shoved onto Angela.
I think a hell of a lot gets shoved onto Angela.
Well, she's coped extraordinarily well under the circumstances, but she just can't hold it all together.
Well, she exerts no parental control over the child. When I was there, the last time I was there, the child poured water onto the floor the whole time. It was climbing up and down on a chair, getting water from a tap, you know? There was water everywhere. It was like a skating rink. I thought it was going to slip and break its neck. She did nothing about it.
Where's Mum?
Dumped the child and vanished.
Charming.
So far defying all attempts to track her down.
So the welfare of the child is very much in question?
Most definitely. But I'd like to suggest we deal with that separately. It has to be dealt with, but I think we should focus on our priorities for Angela first.
Okay, I see. You both seem to have very strong opinions on this girl. Is she better off in or out of the family? Always a gritty one, that. Supervision orders, social services, 8 times in court.
We'll just go on.
She's a rhino, this one.
She is indeed.
Pardon? She's a what?
A rhino. You've not heard that one before?
No.
Good God, woman, where have you been?
Is this rhino as in rhinoceros?
That's right. Really here in name only. R-H-I-N-O.
Oh.
Common reference for a kid who's never at school. We've not heard it before.
Never.
Have now. Each time we go into court, we get nowhere. But good intentions and very few results. It'd dance like easier if she'd robbed a bank. Now it's back to court again for non-school attendance, right, Brian?
For the 9th time.
No more supervision orders. Done with them. Get her into court, officially out of school. An interim care order and interfish treatment assessment. If that works out, I'll fight for the cash to get her into a residential boarding school like Norwich. Sounds great. She won't go, I'll take it myself.
Do you foresee any hope of an improvement in the domestic situation?
Not in the immediate future, no, Mum.
An interim care order, yes?
That is what I would respectfully recommend, Mum. A period of assessment would enable us to make appropriate plans for Angela's future care.
Has a place of residence been arranged?
Fish Street Assessment Centre, Mum, subject to your approval of the care order.
Yes, please.
Yes, I think a very good idea.
We're not going to decide what to do about the charge of theft today. We're going to defer sentence. I will hear this case again at the beginning of my next quarter. If the assessment is good, we shall make an absolute discharge, an interim care order, the placement being at Fish Street Assessment Center. Good. Stand up. Very well. You had better listen very carefully to what this means. It means that you're not to get into further trouble of any kind whatsoever, whether it means coming to this court and getting punished for running away from your school or from the people who are giving their time to try to help you. A lot of people have been expensively involved in trying to keep you in school. It is perfectly obvious to this court that if you are allowed to go on as you are, you're going to get yourself into serious trouble. We simply cannot allow young people to wander the street. You have been stealing, and you have also been involved in a struggle with the police. We do not tolerate violence of any kind. We know you had a difficult time since the death of your mother, and we are going to give you the benefit of the doubt and give you the opportunity to prove that you are of good character. You are to be put into care, and you are to behave yourself to the satisfaction of those people in whose charge you will be placed. This is not a punishment. These people are there to help you. You have got to try to make up for all that schooling you've lost. A report will be compiled on you for me to read when you next appear before me in this court. I want to hear that you have done better than average. Very well.
No, she hasn't. No, she hasn't, Angie. Now look. Come and sit down. She hasn't sentenced you today. That's the whole point. She hasn't fined you or anything. She's going to make up her mind about you when you next come back to court. Now, don't worry. It'll work itself out.
Just a bit of bacon.
What?
Just a bit of bacon. What's all the fuss?
Now, it's not the bacon. It's not just that you've offended. You know that.
John Davis, please. John Davis, this way, please.
I want to go home. I want to go home.
We have to go straight to Fish Street.
What?
I'll pick up your clothes for you.
What for?
Perhaps I can arrange that with you now, mister. We have to go straight to the place you'll be staying. Now, don't worry, it'll be fine. I'll drive you there in my car.
What's gonna happen? I can't. What's gonna happen?
These people, they try to help you.
This is a master. I'll get you your own key.
full at the moment. You're lucky you don't have to share.
When can I go out?
3 days. We can fit you up with some light things or anything else you need, within reason. We've got a stock, or we could let you go out with somebody to buy something.
I want to go home. When can I go home?
Well, that's something to arrange with your social worker. See, a care order means that you have to stay where the social services say you have to stay. I'll give Miss Barker a ring. Well, if you want to go home to pick up some things, she can organise that. It's best to stay here for 2 or 3 days. Get used to it. Settle down. All right.
You all right? You don't look it. You look bleeding awful. Do you want anything? Val, do you want anything?
No.
What are you in here for?
Nothing.
Oi, Val! But it was going to be an all-out struggle. You're a miserable little bugger, ain't you?
Bunked off. That's all. I need to pack it a van.
That all?
Got into a bundle with a policewoman.
You hit her?
Gave her a shove.
Under a bus?
She called me a nigger, so I gave her a shove.
I beat you up in the neck?
No.
Lucky cow, ain't you?
What are you in here for?
What's your name?
Angie.
She jumped on a policewoman and set him alight, didn't you, Ange?
That's right.
Robbery with violence, so watch your bleeding step.
What's it like here?
Here? They're all wankers. Full of stupid little rules and stupid little people who read all your letters. I'm going to wipe my arse on a tissue, put that in an envelope, give them a shot. If you want to fight, you've got to ask your social worker, ain't you, Val?
What?
She's thick, really thick.
I ain't. I've been to the dentist.
My social worker. A right silly cow. She comes breezing in and says, "Hi, I'm your new social worker. How are things?" Bollocks. Bloody awful, miss. How are you? Silly cow.
How long have you been in here?
13 weeks.
Why?
What do you mean?
What are we here for?
Don't you know?
Not really, no. What happens here?
Bugger all. You sit on your arse all day, or they move you around from one spot to another. Or some silly bugger asks you a load of stupid questions, and you're supposed to look concerned about your future. A lot of bollocks. They boss you about, then they take you for trips in a van. They've got a stick in one hand and a carrot in the other. It's just a rubbish dump where they stick little buggers no one likes. Oi, Val!
Shut up.
Go to bed!
What's the school like here?
We just piss about. Teacher reads a book. We don't want to learn. They can't teach.
I'll still go to Northern School.
And she's still thick.
No, I ain't.
Look out, Val, there's a wasp.
Where? Oh, no, getting broke. She kill it, Nicky, kill it.
Shaped wasps.
I ain't wasps, kill it. You're with my big brother.
Is he scared of wasps?
Yeah.
I didn't know men were scared of wasps. Did you, Val?
Where is it? Kill it, Nicky. There ain't no wasp.
There is, on the window ledge. It's going to see your fat ass, Val, unless you go to bed.
How'd you get out of here?
Come on, Val. You lost again. Thank you.
Light your woolly.
Feel sick.
Got any money?
No.
It's a bloody long way. What are you gonna do?
Dunno. Walk. Where's Nikki?
Upstairs with Leon, doing what she shouldn't.
Come on, you lot, let's go.
Give me a top of the skirt and bucket men.
Come on. Hi.
Come on, you lazy bastard. Get up! Get up! Where is he?
What?
Where is he? Where is he? Where's the boy?
Well, I don't know.
You pig, where is he?
He ain't my kid, is he?
You're a pig. Do you know that? You're a pig. You've got no respect. Listen to me, you bugger. Where they take him?
I don't know.
They take the baby away and you don't know. What type of bloody animal are you?
You're not young enough. It's not my fault. I can't do it, can I? I don't know who to look after him, do I?
Who's
doing it? I don't know.
You don't know nothing. They can't do that. They can't just take the baby and not say where they've taken him. Who took him?
I don't know. Look, they left some papers, okay? They left some frigging papers. Just don't ask me.
Where?
They ain't my papers. He ain't my kid. I got my own problems, you know.
Your only problem is what you're gonna do with your dick.
Angie. Thank you. If you come down, I'll make you a coffee. Oh, your social worker dropped off some of your clothes. They're in the wardrobe.
She's a cow. She told me nothing.
She called at 11 o'clock last night to drop off your clothes. There aren't many social workers who'll do that. She's in court today. She has other people to deal with. You're not the only one. I'm sure she'll get to you when she can. You must cooperate, so why not settle down? It's not worth it. You do it again, you'll end up in trouble.
I kind of feel sick. I had 4 takeout on Tuesday. I've been in a hell of a state. don't want us being carb taken, mate. Your gut bleeds. Can I have paracetamol? What's your name?
George.
Can I have paracetamol? Please, George.
Pissing about. The Great Escape. 15 kids once went over the wall at Hatchmere. Push! It's a lock and key place where they lock you up. But 15 kids once went over the wall. It's bloody fantastic. They all right? Bit tight. Well, they ain't your shoes, are they? And I'm bloody freezing.
Help you, dear.
Come to see Charlie Johnson. He's here.
You're a visitor, yes?
No, I'm his auntie. Come to take him away.
You better come in. Who's this been arranged with, dear?
My social worker.
What's your social worker's name?
Miss Barker. I've got the papers.
Can you wait a minute? You'll have to speak to Miss Tandy. You can sit down.
Morning.
Hello.
Stay home.
You're being moved. You're going to a place called Huddleston House, and your assessment will be carried out there. You can get a coat if you want, and if you want to take some pictures, and family snaps, writing paper, you can take those too. But you won't be needing anything else. You'll be leaving in an hour.
You said?
I said.
What for? What have I done?
You know what you've done. I'm not going to catalogue it for you.
Why don't you say I can manage? If you left me alone, I could manage. I don't understand what you're trying to do.
I'm putting you on the transfer list. That's what I'm doing.
I want to see my social worker.
Your social worker knows of my decision. You will see her in due course.
Can't move me, not just like that.
Now, don't tell me what I can and cannot do, young lady. I can, and I am. The decision is entirely at my discretion. I run this home, nobody else. You are being transferred to the Huddleston House Secure Unit, and we will go back to the court and arrange to carry out your assessment from there. So don't argue. It's done.
Come on, Angie. Give him to that man. Remove all your clothes. Right, turn the face to the window. That's it. Okay, that's right. Thank you.
Legs astride. Not your legs. I know how to sit. Turn around. That's right round. That's it. No. Bend over.
It's not right, you know. It's not right.
Wash yourself.
Patel A,
yeah.
Patel D,
sir.
Perkins,
yeah.
Phillips,
sir.
Siri.